everybody, Drew here, tip of the mitt flips, got a haul video for you. I hit the Goodwill and I hit the Salvation Army. I think I spent $30 at Goodwill. Salvation Army, I'm not sure, but I'll put all the totals and selling prices and all that up on the screen for you to see once I figure it out after I'm done filming. So first thing up is a Pfaltzgraf. I think that's how you say that. Pfaltzgraf portfolio. I've never seen this portfolio stuff before, but it's newer Pfaltzgraf, which a lot of that stuff does have a good value. There's a white version that sells pretty good. And then there is a blue and white version that sells okay for certain pieces, not all of them. I've got a platter that's been for sale for 9 months, but if you got a gravy dish, usually those sell pretty good, or sugar, cream and sugar dishes, those sell really good as well. But all of the plates I got at Goodwill were on their only reasonably priced area. They've quit pricing most of their dishware. They just put it on a shelf, 25 cents per piece. So for some stuff that's overpriced still, and for some stuff it's not. These are not in fantastic shape, but there were many of them. There was 15 total. So 15 of these, I'll make one listing. I'll picture the worst ones. That's just to be safe, you know, take pictures of the worst if you're gonna do multiple quantities, multiple listings of the same item, but there's gonna be variances between them. Just take pictures of the worst one. Then your customer might be pleasantly surprised by getting a better item than they thought they were supposed to get. But yeah, I'll probably do these in lots of four, and then hang on to extra ones in case of breakage or lost items or anything like that, any issues that come up, and then I'll have those once they sell, and then I can make a listing with whatever's left at that point. Next up, paid $4.99. I didn't bother looking it up. I saw it was in decent shape. Not great, but good enough. It's a Pyrex 343 1.5 quart, no lid. And if I'm not mistaken, I think this is about a $20 piece even without the lid. I'm not sure if this even comes with a lid. If it does, I probably have one on hand, so that would be a bonus. Next up, another Pfaltzgraf, which if I'm saying that wrong, please correct me. I think it's Pfaltzgraf. It's definitely a PF, so that's a F sound. But yeah, Pfaltzgraf. It's probably got an accent to it, and then it makes it right. But it is, let's see if I can get a name on this. Does not have a name, but when I looked it up, they had a decent value. Again, a quarter a piece for these. I got eight of the smaller salad plates, then also eight of the larger dinner plates, and then two of the bowls, the medium-sized bowl. It's actually this is a perfect cereal bowl size because it's got the high sides. It goes up instead of out. Soup bowls aren't good for cereal. Fun fact, I'm a cereal connoisseur. You want the bowls that go up. That way you can stack the cereal higher, put your hand on it, make sure they don't spill as you're pouring your milk. It's a health tip for you. There you go. But all those still a quarter each. I had eight of each size of plates. So I'll do a listing of four of each of those. And again, 25 cents a piece. So there's definitely some profit there. And again, not in the best shape. I'll definitely just price mine whatever is the lowest price because I paid next to nothing for them. So, but definitely some profit in there. Next up, another dishware item. These are IKEA. It's just a standard dinner plate, tannish white IKEA plate. This is a 17713. Got three of those, 25 cents a piece. If you've been watching for a while, you've realized you've seen me say that I've ventured out into pots and pans a lot more than from zero to quite a bit. There's decent money in it, and just the shipping is so easy because your chance of breakage is pretty slim. I mean, as long as you put some padding around the handle, there's not really much that could happen. This handle's not in the best shape, but this is it's a Vacumatic brand. And I looked them up and there was some decent value in them. This one I paid $6.99 for. I don't remember how much I was getting for it. Obviously, you'll see it right here on the screen. With the lid, that was definitely a selling point for me there. There was two more. This one, which is a Queen's Choice. It looks like the same lid, same handle. So I wonder if that does. Yeah, weird. This is the same brand, but the bottom of this one says Vacumatic by Volrath. And then this one on the side says, oh, it's by Volrath. Okay, so that now we got it. Because it's the exact same, if I can get these flipped around, exact same handles, exact same lids, But this is the Queen's Choice. That sounds fancier. But that was with the lid as well, and I paid $4.99 for that one. And then this was sitting with those, and they had it individually priced, which, you know, I think it's supposed to go with the bigger pan, which I probably will end up doing. I don't know. I'll have to see on pricing. But I went ahead and bought it, $3.99. I figured worst case scenario, I would make up the extra $3.99 by including it, that it would just increase the price that much. I took a shot on that. It seemed logical to me. That was all for the Goodwill. Then I went to the Salvation Army, and I got there right when they were rolling out the carts, which is always the best because you get first pickings. And first thing I saw was a Spalding CS13LX baseball glove. It's baseball season. I don't have any gloves listed currently. I figured I needed some. I sorted through about four or five, and this was the only one worth picking up. $1.99 on that. I love that they stapled it right to it. That's always fun. Then this, I didn't look up. It's a Hallmark ornament hanger. It was blue tag day, so this was actually half off. It was 50 cents, and I didn't look it up or anything, but, you know, you don't have to look something up, but what you do need to do is you need to open it and pull the thing out and realize that the hanger part is not in there. Salvation Army doesn't do returns, so this is on me. That's, you know, 50 cents I wasted. But also time and effort and all that. Just be aware of what you're doing when you're doing it. I thought I was like, oh, I won't even bother looking up. I know this is worth money. It's a Hallmark thing, ornament stand, 50 cents. It'll probably be $9.99 free shipping or something like that. Why bother? I'm smart. And then I wasn't smart enough to open it and make sure that the thing was actually in the box. Maybe there's still value in just the stand. I mean, in just the base. Like somebody breaks theirs or loses theirs. I don't know. Or maybe I can buy a replacement. It just looks like coat hanger, threaded coat hanger. So I'll probably try to recoup my 50 cents. I don't know. I might just throw it away. And then there was a couple pewter pieces like this from, what is it called? Wilton Company pewter. There was three of them, I think. This one was $2.99, but the other two, they all were decently priced, but the other two had some weird discoloration to them. And it looked like, at the very least, a lot of work to clean. And at the worst, like, they were actually damaged. So I just passed. I picked out the one that was clean. I think when I looked it up, it was like 14 bucks, $3. Easy shipper. Put some bubble wrap on it just for looks. Shove it in a box. Good to go. And then this, I did not get when I was thrifting this time. But I got it thrifting from Habitat for Humanity. I can tell by the sticker. But it's just been in my car for who knows how long. I went to get the stuff out and I was like, oh, there's another pan in here. But this is a Revereware. It's a large one, no lid, but the bigger pan at $2.50. There's definitely profit in there. Some Barkeeper's Friend on the bottom, and there's no burnt on. That's one of the keys I'm gonna start looking for. Now that I've ventured out into pots and pans, I'm gonna be a little more selective. If it has the lid, great. If it's clean, really great. But if there's like the charred on, like black bottom, it's just, it goes from being a 2 minute clean job to being an hour clean job to get it off, to the point where I don't even try to get it off. I just hit it with the Barkeeper's Friend, and then it looks weird because it's completely pristine on the bottom, shiny as can be, and then there'll be black dots all over it that stand out. So I think just going forward, I'll avoid it if it's like that, because if not, that's what's going to happen. I'm going to give it a quick clean and list it with the parts on the bottom, with the chunks on the bottom. Because getting those off, usually what it is there's a divot that's been created or a scratch that's been created, and that's just been cooked in there over and over and over again. And it you actually need to use steel wool, like good steel wool, or even some sandpaper maybe. I don't know, some rough grit sandpaper. And then you end up scratching it and wasting your time. So don't do that. If it's charred on the bottom, you know, be prepared. You're going to have to scrub it real hard. And then the last thing, I don't know exactly what's in it. I saw this, and as you can see, this is like a Cars, the movie truck, so it didn't look super appealing, but I start flipping it over to look, and I see this right here, the bottom of this car, which you can't really see there. What I noticed is it said 1970. So I scooped that up for $2.99, this bag here. And of course, there's a couple things in here that are going to be worthless. But I think, in general, these are vintage cars. I see, now that I'm looking, I see a Matchbox Super King 1973. So I think there's actually some decent money in this, especially at $299. Actually, let me open it up. All right, first up, there's some like train set, railroad pieces. If I can identify them, maybe I can put them together and make a dollar on that. I don't know. This might just end up getting thrown in the kid's toy chest. It's kind of cool. It works, you know, up and down, whatever. But I don't know what this goes to. Google Lens. If Google Lens can tell me what these are, then I'll sell them. Google Lens is awesome. I've been using it a bunch. You take a picture with it and it's like, hey, this is what it is. And like a 90% success rate on random things. Little tiny guns and swords to action figures, take a picture of it, boom. It's really amazing. I hope it would be awesome if eBay can integrate that into their system. I mean, that would blow my mind, and that would be amazing. I should write them an email. Will they do that? I don't know. Will they even read my email? Probably not. We got a little Snoopy. It's modern though, so this isn't going to be worth anything. What do we got? Yeah, 2019 McDonald's toy. This is trash. This isn't going to be worth anything at all. Okay, now this might tell me what those are, but maybe not. It's a shovel, but it's Lego. Can you see? Nope, can't see. But it's Lego, and it's got a part number on it. I bet you I'll get $4.99 for this. Like this, just this. Lego bits and pieces, there's decent money in it. Yeah, and like I said, a car's truck with the trailers missing. This is probably worthless. The boy will love it though. He loves the movie. But here's the better stuff. Let's see. Yeah, Matchbox. The trailer says 1970. Yep, Matchbox again for this car, 1970. That's a Cougar Dragster right there. Stickers are a little bit damaged. Actually, I don't think those are supposed to be on there. But it comes with a trailer hitch, so I think maybe this one's... No, that one doesn't go with it, but we'll see. Yeah, and then again right here, Matchbox Super Kings 1971 right there. So, and these are in pretty good shape. Like not fantastic, but mostly just dirty. Not even that bad. So I don't know. I'm excited to look these up. I'll probably, after I'm done filming, get right to listing these, because I don't come across stuff like this very often. Smalls, you know, tinier things that actually have value. I come across a lot of tiny things that don't have a ton of value, but if I got, you know, 10 bucks a piece for all these, that would be awesome. This one doesn't have a year on it, but definitely vintage by Corgi. And I've never heard of that. The wheels are a little banged up, but that's a cool little ambulance. I don't know where or when that was an actual ambulance anywhere. It looks kind of funny. Almost looks like the Ghostbusters car, but a van style. I don't know. And that's just an unbranded trailer. The wheels broke anyway, so that's trash. Here, it looks like a John Deere trailer, but it's not branded John Deere. So, but it does have a name on it. I'll look up, but it says made in China. That's probably not worth a lot. Now this one, I know it doesn't have a brand on it or anything. And this color scheme is weird. The green to blue to yellow. It's a Ford. Ford. But I do know that, because it says it's made in Hong Kong, if you can see right here, probably not. I do know that if you see stuff that's made in Japan, Taiwan, Hong Kong, it's automatically worth more than stuff made in China. As far as toys and collectibles, that's just a good rule of thumb. So you see made in China, probably trash. But Hong Kong, I'll at least look it up. And this is one of those things I'll probably use Google Lens on, because I don't see any branding outside of Hong Kong. And then this one is super cool. Wagon here. Commuter wagon. And this is a Matchbox Speed Kings 1970. Right there. That's cool. It's missing the back window and the side windows, but possibly they just didn't have them. But doors open on both. Like that. Pretty cool. We had a car kind of like this when I was a kid, but it was like that fake veneer wood on the back, and it's got the handle on the back door with the seat facing the other way. Not the coolest looking vehicle, but on beach days, it was awesome. You got 9 kids in a car. And then this is the last one. It's a dump truck. Again, this is Matchbox Super Kings, 1973 right there. So yeah, I'm not sure how much these are worth, but I'm excited to look. You're finding out as you're seeing it, but me, I won't find that out until about, well, it's almost lunchtime. So in like 2 hours, I'll find out. And this one, it has a trailer hitch, but none of these trailers fit it. So that's unfortunate, because it's probably, if I had to guess, because of the stuff on top, it probably came with like a, oh, what do they call them? Like a teardrop camper. And I know those are worth a ton of money. Like the very niche ones, like Matchbox cars, is where the extra money comes in. Like all of them have some kind of value. But when you get to that next tier is the very niche stuff, like your trailers and campers and things like that. Hot dog. I think I saw one that was like a hot dog cart that you pulled behind, but really cool. It's got the luggage on top. If this isn't worth a bunch of money, it'll probably end up here, because this is cool. I like this. Does the back door open? The back door does not open. But that's all for this one. I'll total it up and see what we made here. But I think overall, this is a pretty good haul. Lots of low value stuff that I can put multiple quantity of. So that's always good when you do one listing and you get two or three listings out of that. And then hopefully some higher dollar Matchbox cars. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe, share, and be good to each other.